I will remember being in Washington for the rest of my life. It was an amazing time, and when we arrived, even the hotel room I was in had the monument just outside the window pointing up, and I was thinking the whole time that that pointing up is still trying to remind us, if symbolically and as imperfect as it is, that we're still trying to find higher ground as human beings. I was cognizant the whole time I was there of the fact that I was still a filmmaker stepping into a political world, and I thought that was a great metaphor, allegory, for what Reagan literally did in John Paul II. They stepped from the screen and from the stage into a political and religious slash political arena and had to perform on the world stage.
Here we are, you know, 30 years later, we're still facing a lot of these similar struggles right here in the Western Hemisphere.
What a wonderful thing, film, because I'm very happy to see sort of how John Paul's ideas continue to resonate.
I think this is a very rare kind of thing to happen in the White House, and I just think it's terrific. And I want to congratulate Robert for his magnificent documentary.
I think what The Divine Plan does, and what I've heard from the audience, is that it reminds us that there are things in the world, even politically or religiously, that are worth uniting over and fighting for.